Hello and welcome to the first ever Farming Simulator 22 gameplay presentation. My name is Lars Malcharek and with me is Kenneth Burgess, our QA lead.
Hello. It's Gamescom time,
Lars. It's Gamescom. Yes, it is. We are, well, technically at Gamescom, but not at Gamescom. We are not in Cologne, as you can imagine. We are in our tiny little studio over in Erlangen, and we have the pleasure to show you Farming Simulator 22 for the first time ever, unless you've seen the German presentation an hour ago.
Yeah, we're doing our own Gamescom today.
We are doing our own Gamescom today, not only today, but this week.
Yes, that's true.
So you will see a lot. Yeah, there's a lot of coverage out there, so you will see a lot of coverage. But for now, this is your best chance to have a first look at our, well, new map, because you are taking us to France today.
Yes, so we've shown a little bit about the US map before, and today we are going to Oberon, the French map, our European map, which is a French map. You can already see it here in the gameplay.
Let's go in.
It's a... While the US map is very focused on like big fields and wide areas, the French map itself has more of a like classical touch to it. It's like a European city, so lots of history, lots of old buildings and that.
Smaller fields, of course.
Exactly, smaller fields, smaller roads. We'll have a look at that a little bit later, but for now we're going to start with one thing that we've only shown so far in videos, which is
grapes.
Grape harvesting. There you go. So as you can already see, we have our nice little grapevines here. We've shown it in videos before, how you place them with our new build mode. These grapes, we have grapes and olives. Both of them are new in Farming Simulator 22. And of course, to harvest them, we have our new machine, the New Holland Braut 9070L. It's two of them. We have this one and another one for olives as well. And of course, olives, grapes being new kind of machinery, new kind of like a new feature in the game, that means we need like new equipment, new machines, all of this kind of stuff to properly handle these things.
Yeah, and we'll show more new equipment a little bit later during that presentation, because there's more to grapes than only harvesting them, of course.
That's
but
true.
Yeah, we're going to talk about that later. For now, we start harvesting, and you already said it, you place these grapes via the Terrain Builder.
Yeah, the build mode.
Yeah, the build mode. It's pretty much the same as you would place a fence, basically. Same system. You put them there, and then the grapes start growing. And then at one point, you use this lovely machine to make sure you have your grapes nice and dandy.
Yeah, and as you can already see, something that's like a little bit tricky, because it's a new feature. So of course, it's going to take a little while to get used to as well. These grapevines, they have their own collision. So what you need to be wary of while harvesting them is to properly align the machinery with it, as you can see here.
I'm already having problems with it. It's super hard to do in first person mode, of course.
Yeah,
but there we go.
Because it's like a little bit of an offset in there. But yeah, basically they have their own collision, so you have to navigate it properly along these vines to get your grapes in the end. As you can see here, we already have the effects in play, the small little grapes going down onto the conveyor belts, and the small little cut pieces of leaves and other things in the back. So, and once we finish this row, I can also show you another piece, a new piece of equipment that we have. So, already parked over here, you see one of our new trailers, which is needed for grapes, because grapes are not like grain, you know, you can't just put them into any kind of trailer. They are like very delicate.
Yeah, you have to be a little more careful with them.
Exactly. Otherwise you get
Produce
jam.
Grape juice even before you started.
Yep.
Actually
before you started producing it. So we're going to go over here and then start overloading our grapes into the trailer.
Yes, and that is a very special trailer. We're going to show a nice little trick with it in a minute.
Yep, you can also see it's one of the new Fuhrmann trailers that we have in the game, just specifically for grapes.
Yeah, and with it is a very old Steyr, the 8150. That one, you can tell it's not one of the modern tractors.
Yeah, it doesn't have the round aerodynamic kind of design. It's just this classical almost block-like in the design. I really like those.
That's how it used to be. And now we're going to show you this nice little trick with the trailer, because you can close it.
Yeah, we can just basically close it now since we're full. And you can like place it anywhere on the field. So if your harvester is on the other side, you can also open it
to the other side.
On the other
nice.
Side. So it's pretty flexible. And that way, if you want to like open it on the left side or on the right side, as you can see here. Oh, look at these NPC card.
Yeah,
the
you
traffic
can tell
just
traffic
darting
has been
along.
Traffic has been fastened up by a lot. They are faster now.
Yeah, they basically can tell better. Like the collision detection works a bit better, so they will see if you're coming, slow down. And since it's better, we can also have them drive a bit faster as well.
Yeah. And that was requested a lot by you guys out there, so it's a good thing
exactly.
that this happens.
So as you can hopefully hear now, I will start driving, and you see it's kind of like an older tractor. It has some weight that it needs to pull. We're going to take this little side road here leading up, and you can already see and also hear our gear shifting system that comes into play.
Yeah, and we do have a gearbox system in play. We spoke about that before. Manual gear shifting is possible.
Oh, look at that. Look at that. There's like a small little... Oh, a few of them are actually running around. So we have... These are currently still very work in progress, and we're looking to implement them for the final release. But yeah, a little bit of more wildlife coming into the game here.
Very nice. Yeah, we should mention that everything, of course, is work in progress.
Yeah.
This is an in-development version of the game. A lot of things have been disabled as well for Gamescom.
That's true,
because
yeah.
we're going to have a couple of YouTubers and everything in here.
They're going to use the same build
they
that you
use
see
that build.
Right now.
Exactly. So it is a very specific build made for Gamescom. So not everything you see will be like this in the finished product, right?
That's true.
So about the sound, you're in the cabin now, so you guys should
It's also different like compared to outside.
You should be able to hear that the sound has changed a lot. I'm going to... Shut down for a second to give you a tiny idea of how it sounds now. So we made a lot of adjustments when it comes to sound.
That's true. There's a lot of like fine little minute details that went into like the sound design of FS22. I think we're pretty proud of what we can show off so far.
Absolutely, absolutely. It sounds amazing. And I think it looks amazing as well. We're going to show you guys a little bit more about, especially about the parallax occlusion mapping later on. There might not be the best chance now because, there is a building, but there are way more interesting buildings when it comes to parallax occlusion.
Yeah, that's true.
Once we hit the village.
What we have here is now our grape processing plant. So there's like many different factories in the game, many of these production chain elements. So what you can do... Best example being like the grain mill and bakery, for example. If you usually focus on like harvesting grains, you can then buy a grain mill and gather your harvest, bring it there, and produce it into flour. And of course, that flour, you can always like decide for yourself, do you want to sell the grain directly? Do you want to sell the flour? Or if you own a bakery, you can, of course, just take that and create bread or a cake.
Yeah, exactly.
All of these things are possible. And of course, the more you produce with your goods, the more money you're going to get in the end.
Yeah. And this is something that a lot of you guys asked for. Is it possible to basically not use production chains? Yeah, it absolutely is.
You can
totally just deliver the stuff, sell it, and you're done, right? But you can also...
Exactly.
decide to use the production chains like we do right now and, for example, produce grape juice. That's what we are going to do now.
Yeah, so let me open up this production point here. So here you can see at this particular factory, the grape processing unit, we have the ability to either produce raisins or grapes. We already have some, as you can see on the right side, some storage. So there's already lots of grapes stored in there, and we just brought in a few more. So what we can do now is basically activate it. And you can see in the lower right now that stuff is happening. It's slowly starting to produce these like pallets of grape juice. The liter counter is going up. So let me actually just fast forward a bit. so we don't have to wait a whole day for a pallet to finish.
Yeah. And that's something we changed as well, right? Is the information window on the lower right side.
Yeah.
It's way more precise than
it's very context dependent as well. Like if you're looking, like I'm doing it now, at a production point, it gives you all of the information you need there. If you're looking at a vehicle, oh, there we go.
There we go.
If you're looking at a vehicle, you get all of the information there as well. And if you're looking at a field, for example, you can always see, like, what's the current growth stage? How is it fertilized? How is the, like, who does it belong to? These kind of things.
So way more in-depth than it used to be.
Yeah, exactly.
In previous games.
So.
The Jungheinrich Stapler.
Yes, we have a new vehicle here as well with a new brand. Now you need to know I am not the best loader of them all. I'm very bad at this and I have the utmost respect of people who do this even with a controller.
Yeah, so well, that was good though. I've seen worse doing more test runs.
Yeah, that's true, but I can't get it right. Every time there's something that's in the way. All right, so here we go. Let's load our pallet. Oh,
nice.
Look at that first try.
Very good.
So now we're going to strap this on, enter our vehicle, and we're going to show you a little bit about the map as we now are going to make our way to one of the selling stations that's on the map. So we're going to go to the farm shop, and yeah, as you can see, we're right about to head into a little bit of more of a more like civilized area. Oh look, there's another car. So yeah, we didn't talk about it yet, that the like cars and also the NPCs in the game, they all are specific to the map. So you will see different kind of models depending on what map you're playing on.
You might have seen that the car that just passed us is, well, it was inspired by a very, very famous French car.
Mm-hmm.
In German, we call it the Duck, the Ente.
Duck.
I don't actually know the real name of it, to be honest. Because for my whole life, it just has been the Duck.
The Duck.
So, but yeah, it is a very French car. And we can stop at any point here and show the parallax occlusion mapping, because that's exactly what I'm talking about.
Yeah.
These are the buildings I was talking about. This map is full of these buildings, and you can tell that there is a nice little 3D version of it now because of parallax occlusion mapping. You can see the stones really stand out.
Yeah, and this is like with all of the different textures that we have, it just really makes the world kind of just pop.
Yeah, and that works for everything. I mean, we've just shown a wall, but if you
works
would check out the ground
well,
or
yeah.
anything, and we're going to show ground a little bit later again, because it might not be as interesting for you guys on the road. It will be more interesting, of course, on a field. But
yeah, but as you can see here, like the subtle touch on the French map is just this big part on history. You see there's like buildings and also walls from probably like medieval times as well. There's a castle on the map as well, which is just typical for like old European cities, because compared to the US, cities have been very, very old.
Yeah, absolutely, especially France. France has a rich history. I mean,
yeah.
You know, and it's nice to have this little touch in there. It really makes the map feel completely different from the
true.
US map. And the other way around, of course.
We wanted to have like these just two distinct feelings of playing an atmosphere that you're in while playing. So we're now at the farm shop. Also, you might notice like the names, they're also very local, very French, in this part of the game, of course.
Not for the billboards, though, but then again, advertisement is international. And of course, these billboards might change
for the
game in the end.
So let's drive to our pallet selling point here, and you can see as our money is being deducted, and you can also hear it, the pallet is now slowly being unloaded.
I hope the money is not deducted. I hope it increases.
Increased, yes. It's added to our account, not deducted.
So yeah.
It's those taxes, man.
Yeah. It's hard. No, we just sold our grape juice. That is nice. Supermarket will be happy.
Yep, they will be very happy, hopefully.
We are
Let's just
done
park here.
For here. Yeah, and you can see a couple more of these cars that are, as we said, very specific for the European region.
Mm-hmm.
Even if we do have a car, let's phrase it that way,
a car yeah,
on that
true.
Map that is very American, but we still have it on that map. We're going to show it a little bit later.
So, what do we have here? This is the Mercury 4000L. This is also new. And as we've talked before, I can like also show it again. Some of you might have seen the Gamescom video that we did showcasing like the new crop types, where we actually like filmed in a like really like this grape vineyard kind of location. And these vines are really close together, also like just like they are in real life. So this means that we need like specialized machinery. As you can see here, our Fendt tractor, it's like very, very slender, very, yeah, very narrow. Like if you look from it from the front, it's almost like ridiculously narrow because it's like specialized to drive in these small areas. Same as with the spreader, the sprayer here in the back. You can't just take any of the ones that you would usually know from our game. This is like a specialized one as well, which as you can see, once I turn it on here, is used to basically fertilize these grapevines.
Yeah, that looks very nice. I totally like it. You might wonder what the thing at the front of the tractor is. We're going to go over this a little bit later.
Mm-hmm. We're going to show that later.
Yes. So now, you can see that this sprayer is doing its job. It's really nice. It's interesting because, yeah, technically, you know, sprayer have been in the game.
Yeah.
For a long time.
But this is a very specialized version.
This is a very special, very new version of a sprayer that we haven't shown before.
Yeah, that's true. And here, in our class Trion, we're going to show you another new crop type, which is sorghum.
Yes.
Very American, actually, because it was something that we implemented since we've seen like lots of American players asking for it. There were lots of mod maps of as well that implemented that. So
we basically same for grapes, right? A lot of you guys out there asked for grapes.
Yeah, exactly.
And yeah, here we are.
So now you can also see something that's new, our new particle effects, which is on a lot of the new machinery we have implemented into the game. And you can see that similar to like the textures, thanks to parallax occlusion, this is also very much more three-dimensional and kind of just looks so much better than it did before, where it was just these different planes. This is actually like proper particles that are being ejected here.
Absolutely. And if you switch to the interior view, you're going to see that it has changed in the front as well. This looks way better.
The intake animation is also specialized now on most of our assets.
So it all looks better, cleaner, more realistic.
Definitely.
And
I really like the texture of sorghum in general, because as you can see, the not only with the new ones but also the old ones, we like revised all of the textures for our different crop types as well.
And once you finish this line, we might just jump out and show the ground because it really looks good. And there is this not so French vehicle that we spoke about to the right. We're gonna go over that Mack truck in a second.
Yep. We'll be using it.
It obviously is a little bit, you know, not very French, let's phrase it that way, but we really wanted to show you guys the Mack truck because a lot of you asked for it.
Yeah.
So we put it on that presentation so that you guys have a chance to take a look at this very beautiful truck.
So here we can see the ground again.
Yeah.
And also, like, just generally with our parallax occlusion, everything just looks so much more three-dimensional in its appearance.
Absolutely does. It looks way better.
So let's turn around here, get our Mack truck to work a bit, and then we can show you a little bit more of the city.
Yep.
We're gonna drive through it. So there's also like a special version of this one, this particular Mack truck. I don't know if you want to talk about
it. Yeah, there is the Black Anthem edition, which is a pre-order bonus.
So this is basically the one you see in the game as is.
Exactly. So because a lot of you guys out there ask if you only get a Mack truck if you buy it on Amazon. No, it's just a color version, a different color version of the Mack truck that we have in the game.
Exactly.
So there is a Mack truck for every one of you. And that one is beautiful. We're going to show the interior as well in a second. There we go. It just looks good.
So now, very untypical, of course, driving across a small little field road with this big truck.
Yeah, but we blocked a lot of our driveways with the other tractors. So
yeah, that's true. So let's just get over here.
Take a little detour, show a nice little house in the middle of nowhere. And these are the tiny little details you spoke about before.
Yeah, like just like these remnants of some lost or ancient history, perhaps.
And I mean, you know, it's basically it's like a village. It's more than fields. It is a village, so there has to be something.
And it's like that in real life as well.
Nice. Yeah, absolutely is.
So let's get out here and make our way to the city. We're not going to be driving all the way to the farm shop, but I just want to show you guys a little bit more of the
city, because it's beautiful.
Yeah, the classical location of Aubelron. Because as you can see already in the distance here, the architecture as well, it's very historical. It's very, well, not ancient, but just very like classical in its appearance.
Yeah, absolutely. And you can still see the 3D rooms that we introduced with the Alpine DLC for Farming Simulator 19.
Exactly.
So houses look way better now.
That map, of course, is also part
of Farming Simulator 22, but it got an overhaul, though.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, with all these new things that we have, it's been like retouched as well.
Yeah. So if you played the Alpine expansion for Farming Simulator 19, you already know what to expect from the map, because it is the same map, it just looks better. And here we see some of the NPCs, you said it before. They are tied to the map as well.
Yeah, to the map itself.
So you will see more European cars, especially on the European map, and you see more American style things, and you
fashion
else.
Choices
you
as well.
Stop there and show the boats again.
Yep.
Because
let
I
me
like
just walk down. Let's just park, and everybody will be angry at me
for
halting in the middle of the road.
Let's call it park for a minute, because this is something nice. Of course, there is no. It's not a selling point or anything. There is no value of these boats other than they are beautiful, they are nice to see.
It's just
and
like there's
nice
there are many different there. Like on both maps there are very many different like kind of small areas that are just like nice to visit or
just to explore,
and also something which we also haven't talked about yet except in the stream before is that curious minds will be rewarded, perhaps, because
exploring is a thing again.
Yeah, we have collectibles hidden throughout all of the game. Each like separate collectible sets, so to speak, on each map, of course. So here, actually, on the French map, it'll be a set of like old video game cartridges that you can find and collect.
And if you collect them, you said that before in the stream we had like 2 hours ago, then you get them to watch to look at
exactly.
Your home.
And there's like this little area in your garage at the starting farm, and that's basically where you can put them in, and you'll get like a nice little image.
Nice.
So,
yeah, some of you who played Farming Simulator 17 do remember that we used to have collectibles. Back in the day, it were gold nuggets.
Mm-hmm, yeah,
and
gold nuggets
are back. A lot
true.
Of you guys ask for collectibles to come back.
Everybody missed those gold nuggets.
And I've actually seen a couple of cool things back in the days from modders doing with collectibles.
Yeah.
So I'm very interested to see.
I'm also like a big collector myself in all kinds of games. So it's like very nice to see that if you're somebody who likes exploring the map, likes to look around, that you're kind of rewarded in that way.
Yeah, and I feel like this map actually, you know, it's worth exploring. It's a nice map.
Definitely.
It looks really good. We're going to show you guys the castle.
We're going to take a small little hike up here. Small little detour.
Yeah. There we go. There is the castle.
You can see it's already nice up there. And of course, with all these things, almost anything you can see, you can like visit. Be it on foot, or I mean, you can try driving a tractor up there, but I wish you good luck. But it's easier to just walk. And of course, these are also locations where maybe the collectible or two might be hidden.
Yeah, we are not telling.
We're not spoiling any.
It's on you to find them.
Any locations. So there you go. like another big ancient piece of history. I'm not going to go inside because players might want to do that for themselves, but I want to show you guys something different. Yeah,
but you can go inside, so that is something
definitely.
You should be aware. You can totally do that. So yeah, lots of exploring possible on that map. You might really want to do that if you play that map. Not everyone will play all the maps, I understand that, but I think it's totally worth playing, to be honest.
Definitely, yeah. So let's see, because here we go. There's another small little location here with something very cool. It's not totally random, but it's just one of these nice little touches of the map. We have a catapult just sitting here.
Yeah, ready to be shot.
well, you can't actually shoot it. But look at this view.
If you ever visited like France or even Italy, I remember seeing them in Italy as well.
Mm-hmm.
There are actually catapults every now and then. You know, of course, they're tourist attractions. So,
yeah.
You know, you have to go to a castle and then they're there. You pay entrance fee to see them. But
definitely.
They are there. And it's nice to have one of these standing there.
Just as a kind of little bit of a flair.
Exactly.
There's some baguette here as well in the interior.
Yeah. Again, 3D interior is a thing now. It makes the map look so much more alive.
Exactly. Really. So, what we can show after
we could show cultivating.
We could show cultivating
first. Why not?
Because there is a new feature that we haven't talked about yet.
No.
Completely.
Except for the stream that we had 2 hours ago.
Yeah.
It is cultivating. No, it's not. Cultivating has been here, but if you check out that cultivator, you're going to see that a little bit has changed on the ground. You might have noticed these tiny little pebbles every now and then.
Just pop up.
And yeah, it here looked like it's them. Stones. And the reason for that is because it actually...
They are stones.
Are stones.
Yeah, that's one of our new features in the game. So always depending on what kind of... machinery you're using, of course, there's the possibility for stones to be dug up while cultivating, or especially like bigger ones and more if you're using like a subsoiler or a plow, for example. And these are just an additional gameplay element that, if not taken care of, you if you drive over them with your machinery, they're going to take increased damage and wear from that.
So you have to bring your machines into maintenance more often if you drive over them.
Bring it to the workshop and having them take care of repairing all of your equipment.
Good news is you don't have to drive over them because we do have a new special piece of equipment and we are just driving toward it right now.
Yep.
To remove these stones, there we go. You can see it on the right side. It is a stone picker.
So let me get this out of the way. Yeah, and over here, it is our Elho Scorpio Stone Picker. So also a new brand, of course. And
the Zetor.
And our Zetor Tractor. So, as you've already said, the tool itself, pretty simple. It's used to pick up the stones. That's why it's called a stone picker. And remove them from your field. And it's actually going to be like a proper fill type. So... once you start picking those stones up, you'll see it in our... Whoops, I need to turn it on, of course, as well. You'll see it in the lower right that we are gathering stones, which then, of course, can be used. There's like... you can place them yourself, or there's already like a few positions on the maps where you can then deliver those stones to for a small little bit of money on the side, basically.
To a debris crusher.
Yeah, a debris crusher, basically. And that's what you can do with the stones. You can see also here some nice little new effects as they are all gathered up. I really like our new ground effects. Like with any kind of machinery, they just look so much more better nowadays.
Yeah, they look way more realistic than they used to. I mean, they looked good before, but yeah, we changed all things for Farm Simulator 22. And it shows. It absolutely
yeah,
does.
Just trying to give it that extra push, basically. So,
now,
of course, this is our...
You want to show this now? Yeah, why not? Let's do it.
Our pre-order bonus. So Lars, how? It's the
class saddle track.
How can we get one of these?
Well, you just have to pre-order. It doesn't matter where you pre-order. The class saddle track is included in every single pre-order out there. So other than the mech track, that is only for the day one edition on Amazon. Mm-hmm. That one is with any pre-order you place, really.
Yeah, and you can also see we have like new kind of ground textures for a slurry as well. So let me drive over here a little bit to show you both.
Yeah, and it's kind of hard to see on the right side, on the darker side. However, and I'm quite sure you're going to show that in a minute because you did it last time, you will see it very good once you take a closer look, especially against the sun.
Yeah, so you that can see where now.
Right now,
now
it's there.
Here.
This is not the best position for the sun to be in, but you can tell.
You can see that it's like definitely it has this kind of like sheen.
Yeah,
it
has a little bit of wet look, basically. Yeah. It looks a little bit
just
wet.
Just this moist kind of dirt. And you can also see that the earth itself, due to the parallax occlusion, just looks far more three-dimensional here as well.
And you can tell the difference. I mean, the sun is right up there right now, so it's a little bit... Well, it's not too ideal to show the effect. But yeah, I think it was very visible.
What we're going to do now is, it's like... in the middle of August right now, so what we're going to do is we're going to sleep.
Yeah, because we want to show the other equipment we just spoke about
for
grapes.
Grapes.
And we can't do that right now. We need to wait for the grapes.
Because like that's the thing with the seasonal growth that we have in game. So all of these elements are basically, they all adhere to like the seasonal growth pattern. So different fruit types can only be planted at different seasons. They can also only be harvested at different seasons. And of course, it has like this effect on weather, on the lighting of the world itself. You will see now that once we're done sleeping, it's October right now.
Yeah.
And we have the nice little leaf color changes, of course, which is very, very pretty.
Yeah, it looks really good. You see the difference in the entire lighting, basically.
Exactly. And here we go. So this is our new Otsea. I think it's Otsea. Yeah, Otsea is the brand that we have in the game. And we're going to be cutting down some of these grape leaves because these vines, they, similar as we've had it before with sugarcane in the game, they need to basically be pruned. That's what it's called. So you cut back these leaves and that will allow them to grow back on their selves, like on their own for the next year.
Yeah. So you only have to place them once, unless you remove them by force.
Mm-hmm.
They will stay there and you can just prune them and then have them grow again.
And this
harvest
will allow them
and
to grow
so on.
Back.
Right.
So you can also see the nice effects that
just
we have.
Just very quick
here.
Because you spoke about it. There is a harvesting calendar now.
Yeah, we can actually show it over here.
Show the crop calendar.
And where we are in that timeline right now as well.
And so you can see some things can be planted right now, some things can be harvested right now, and with some things you can't do anything right now. However, this is something that's entirely optional. You can turn it off if you don't like it, if you feel like you want to play it like you used to, where you don't have to think about these things and just do whatever you like. You can totally do that, and seasons will still be there. There's still snow in the winter.
There's still
going to
be like the visual.
It has
part,
no effect on the gameplay.
Weather effect, but yeah, it's basically if you want to plant your corn anytime you want to, then you can do so.
Yeah,
that's something that's always very important for us when we're introducing these new types of features. We always want to make sure that the player still has the choice to decide if they want to play with it or without it.
Yeah, and I think we've said that before. If we make the game more realistic at some points, we're going to make sure that people who don't like it don't have to use it. Because we know that there are a lot of different play styles. And we also know that there are a lot of young players who just want to, you know, not think about these things, just drive a tractor. And this is absolutely fine. You can totally do that. On the other hand, if you really like to play more realistic, have
there's
fun
the option.
With that. And this, I think, marks the end of our tiny little Gamescom presentation, doesn't it?
That's all we wanna we can show for now.
Exactly. It's not all we have to show, though. It's all we gonna show on Gamescom. Mm-hmm. There are a couple more surprises we have in the back. I know a lot of you guys ask for that very specific UI thing you saw back at FarmCon. We are not talking about that during Gamescom. So stay tuned for more information on that.
I mean, definitely in general, from now to launch, there's like still lots of small snippets of information.
Yes.
And I think
fact sheets are starting very soon. They are starting early September. I mean, this is end of August.
Yeah.
So as you can imagine, fact sheets are literally around the corner, basically. So you're going to see fact sheets very soon. We, as we said, we still have a couple of surprises that we can come up with, even if, to be fair, most of the stuff we have shown by now, you know, the second map now. So yeah, still a couple of things to come. Stay tuned for that. Thank you for your time, Mr. Kenneth.
Of course.
And to everyone out there, and of course to you, have a fantastic weekend now. For us, the weekend will not really start because it's still Gamescom, so we're going to have a couple more things to do tomorrow. No weekend during Gamescom week. That is just what it is. But for you guys, have a fantastic weekend. We hope you liked what you've seen, and we are looking forward to see you again next time we are here, or maybe just on the field. Bye.
Bye-bye.